But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
What's good, y'all? It's me, Old School, and I'm here with special guest Pat Harrington.
Hey, what's up?
Dude, Pat.
Oh, check this shit out, guys.
Pat painted this for me before the movie, dude. Like, sick, dude. How long did this take you?
About 45 minutes.
So, Pat, you're a fan of movies. You like movies, right?
Yes.
And you watch my reviews, don't you?
Every single one.
You're the only one who does.
I doubt that. I've seen your reviews.
Well, that's why we got you here, man. So, we saw Creed 2. Now, I did my singular review, you know what I mean? I gave my thoughts on it or whatever. But this is the spoiler where we're going to talk about everything in the movie. So if you didn't see it and you want to see it, this video is not for you to watch, okay? Go watch something else. Go watch the first one. Creed 2, the movie where Creed fights Drago. Right? Now, like, right off the bat, I mean, like, we knew he was going to win.
Well, yeah, but it was definitely different than what I thought it was going to be. It was definitely good. And like I said, it wasn't as good as I thought it was going to be. Not as good as I hoped it was going to be, but it was worth going to see.
I didn't expect to have them fight twice. The minute I saw that they had a fight in the middle of the movie, I was like, oh, this is the Mr. T fight from 3 where he's going down, he's losing, getting knocked out, and then he's going to have to come back and win. Drago throws in the towel for his kid because Creed is just beating the living fucking shit out of him. Just got him in the corner. He's just rocking him with jab after jab after jab. Dude, it's out of fucking control, man. I don't know. I didn't think it was going to go that route, but when it did go that route, I was happy.
Like you said, as we were walking out, it was more about the heart of the character, which was nice to see. I mean, you know, how much can you really do with a boxing movie that hasn't been done? But
it's either you win or you lose. But when you see the trials of their lives, and actually the weird relationship between Drago and his kid, you like could see, at least I could see, because I guess Brigitte Nielsen leaves Drago because he sucks and he lost the fight, right? So the whole movie is like, we've got to get back the hot blonde chick. She ain't even hot no more. She never was. No, but it's
not even fucking close.
Not even close. The whole movie, I was like, oh, this kid's gonna break eventually. I didn't know how, if like he was gonna turn on his dad, kind of the way that Drago turned on his manager and the fight member.
That's how, like, I thought it was gonna go too. Like, especially when he noticed that his mom wasn't going in, I thought he was gonna throw in the towel himself.
His mind now is completely out of the fight. That's it. My boy might get fucking hurt now. There was that sweet moment though where Drago went to Adrian's restaurant, right? And like Rocky said something to him.
Wait, he said about putting the dogs down?
Yes, dude, that was the shit. It was just like, yo, there was a moment where it was a little like Drago stood up and Rocky flexed. Dude, and as we know in real life, Drago is much younger than Rocky, so it's like, now, fuck, dude.
He's another one I wouldn't want to throw down.
I'm going right for the knees, but climbing up fucking like a squirrel.
Right.
It's ear punches. It's not even ear punches. There was no real surprises from the actual boxing aspects.
No.
But I think from a true continuation standpoint, you could like stop Creed 1, start this, roll right 3, feel right? Hopefully going to be a 3.
I hope so. I mean, they got to redeem themselves. I mean,
well, now is when they're going to turn it up and start bringing in the crazy characters with mohawks and like, okay.
Wait, let's see. How much crazier do you want? Fucking Drago's son was fucking insane.
Dude, that guy's a beast. I mean, like, we're like bigger guys. No, dude, that guy would make us look like little, like, Gary Coleman size, like, people.
Like watching that fucking mountain guy get in the fucking ring with boxing gloves.
I definitely think that we can continue this story because Creed's just now kind of realizing that he has to be his own man, which happened in about the second act to the third act of the movie. So the characters can grow, but they're going to have to figure out how to do it like Rocky Balboa, the movie, where there's one fight in that movie. It's really hard because I knew there would be no goddamn way that this would be as good as Creed going into it. Really, there isn't even anything too much to spoil. It's just repetitive is the thing. Of course he loses. Of course he wins. Rocky stays there. It has the nice family moment at the end, which gives it some closure. So basically, I just wanted to introduce you to my boy, Pat, dude, who's part of the High Evolution team, man. He's a sick artist, tattoo artist, and we're going to be hitting the road throughout 2019. You're going to see us everywhere.
Y'all motherfuckers don't even know what's coming.
No, you don't. Unless you might post, and then you might. But aside from that, no clue. All right, man. This is signing off for the final review of 2018 Part 2. I'm Old School.
I'm Pat.
And this is Old School Reviews. See you in January of 2019. Peace.